I was not very surprised about the education about sexual assault and how minimum it was. It didn't really engage me or teach me anything new about sexual assault.
As a freshman in orientation and in welcome week, we have certain classes on sexual harassment and what to do in those situations, but I think that's great and we should have those, but I think that individually people should not need those classes to understand that sexual harassment, you know, is not acceptable.
For somebody who might log into Haven who's been working with issues of sexual and relationship violence and violence in general, might be like, okay, click, 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 click. And that's not very engaging for them, but then folks who might grapple more with this topic or might not be as familiar might have a more difficult time, one, being engaged or finding the incentive to participate in a module such as that.
1 in 4 women report surviving rape or attempted rape at some point in their lifetime, in comparison to reported 1 in 71 men.
I think that rape and sexual assault are a problem on campus.
Yeah, definitely. Rape and sexual assault are a problem on this campus and on pretty much every campus in the United States.
I do think rape and sexual assaults are a problem on campus.
I think rape and sexual assault are a problem on campuses across the entire country, not just on the U of M campus, but yeah, I would say it's a concern here.
I think the U definitely could do more because it clearly is an issue. You hear about it all the time, and you also hear about not only at the U, but in a lot of campuses, people getting away with it.
For most reported rape cases, a man was the perpetrator, 98.1% of the time when a woman was the victim, and 93% of the time when a man was the victim.
Our administration doesn't put nearly enough funds and enough money toward that program. Like, I know that the program is pretty much just run off of volunteers at this point. And when we have a campus that is this big, where you potentially have about 60,000 like grads and undergrads that are here at a given day, the prevalence of sexual harassment, sexual assault, like stalking, is so high. And right now there's not enough money being devoted.
As college students, we constantly see money being poured into programs where only a few students benefit. Meanwhile, the Aurora Center is for all students, but receives insufficient funding.
The university does have an obligation to minimize sexual violence on campus.
If you see something, to say something, so being an active bystander. The Men's Engagement Initiative at the Aurora Center is kind of trying to bring more men into the center and male-identified and masculine of center folks in general on both prevention efforts as well as being facilitators to our volunteer program and trying to encourage men and masculine folks to really engage and be agents for change.
You kind of have to use some empathy and put yourself in the perspective of a person who would be going through that. And I think once you understand from that perspective, it's pretty powerful to see that, you know, that's completely wrong.
To the men out there that like are definitely against harassment and sexual assault, we need you to speak out about it, because not saying anything isn't making anything better.
The presence of a bystander makes a completed rape 44% less likely.